Our methods are innovative. We also expect our students to be able to think out of the box given the training we provide them. We expect them to pursue excellence and we expect them to be good at teamwork. A little bit about future schools. So this is our mandate to push the frontiers of teaching and learning practices at the school-wide level and beyond. Use educational technology meaningfully, effectively. IT is pervasive in this school. It's pervasive, yet it's purposeful. It's not IT for IT's sake. We have no KPIs to do with ICT. We're not interested in measuring how many times we use ICT in the classroom. We're not interested. Okay. What we want is for ICT to be meaningful, purposeful, and hopefully it makes our teaching and learning more effective. We also have staff who engage in research to develop and evaluate new IT tools and or pedagogies. I've already told you this, there are 8 of us. 3 primary schools, 5 secondary schools. We are one of the 5. Ours is a student-centric holistic curriculum. What exactly do I mean by that? We have 4 key pillars, one of which is academic rigor. That's the second pillar, character and citizenship education. This is the third, more of that later, 21st century competencies. And this is also how we interpret the word future as future school. We want our students to be future ready. So that means we have to equip them with 21st century competencies. What exactly are those 21st century competencies? I'll show you in a little while. And the fourth pillar is technology. We use technology meaningfully. Our teachers know that if you don't design for it, it's not going to happen. You want the child to be equipped with the 6 21st century competencies, you've got to build it into your lesson. So they have to design their lesson to make it happen. And they do that using curriculum innovations, new pedagogies, and 21st century assessment. Now what do I mean? We have communicative arts. We want our students to be skilled communicators, don't we? So we put together English language and English literature, put the two together and call it communicative arts. So at secondary one, which is grade 7, at secondary one, our students do communicative arts instead of English language and literature. It makes the subject come alive, they love the language better, and they have fun. They become more confident in using the language. Skilled communicators.
My colleague will give you an iPad. This is not a present, not a welcome. Later we need to collect it back, okay? So I'm going to show you, if you recall, we actually partner, industrial partner, to actually develop certain apps. So this is one of the apps that we've developed with Rockmoon. So it's called Trail Shutter. Usually when we go bring kids out for excursion, right? So we'll give them a worksheet, a booklet that they'll fill in and all. But there is no immediate feedback. There isn't multi-model submission. You know, you can engage kids with video, you know, online web pages and all these things. So sometimes it's difficult to hold their attention. So what we come up with, this is what we call Chill Shutter, where we can upload videos. We can have them answer MCQ questions where they'll receive immediate feedback. And then at the same time, they can actually go around with this app just learning on their own. Okay, but letting you to have a trial on the app, but before that, I will bring you through certain features of the app. So we want to make sure that they actually start on the same page. So we actually have this video where we actually downloaded from YouTube and we put it. Okay, to make sure that they have some basic knowledge before they start the trail. Okay, so after they watch the video, then they can start the trail. So when they start the trail, the first thing they need to do is actually to check in. Yeah, there are different hot spots. So you see there are four different hot spots. So it's actually four different tasks they need to do. Okay, so each task actually has video questions, or they need to take photo to actually upload to our system, then we can assess them later. Okay, I'll give you 5 minutes or so. You explore the app yourself. If you have any question, let me know. I will drop by.
Are you trying to look at it?
Is because we realize that when kids are on computer, very often they don't work or talk to one another. So we need a collaborative space for them as well. So besides using their own personal learning device, so this is what we have developed. So this device actually allows four people to work together in a group. If you look around, right, the chairs are actually color-coded on purpose. Okay, so that when we come in, right, so the teachers can just shout out the color. Red color, you'll be the team captain of the day. Then the black color will be the note taker for the day, and so on.
So all the teachers from different subjects, they will do this same thing.
Yes, correct. There are some apps actually developed for certain subjects. I will show you a generic app first. So this app is what we call the collaborative space. Sweet. Okay. So there are different templates. Okay, mainly for brainstorming. So there are different structures that we have put in, actually, like 5W1H, Y chart, and so on. Okay, and of course, if you are, let's say you don't want to use any of these templates, it's fine, there's a blank template as well. Okay, so I'll just show you one of the simpler one. I believe everyone is familiar with SWOT, right? Okay, so what happened is the kids are here, then you see there are four corners, so each one will take one. So if you don't mind, let's join the group together. Okay, so. Sir? Yeah. So you will type your nickname or the name, then we will join.
Okay, join.
But there are some apps actually developed by our teachers with vendor. Mm-hmm. So for example, in the teaching of mathematics, right, if you are familiar, so we actually learn coordinates and so on, right? So angle, the elevation angles and the angle of depression and so on. So our teachers came out with this game whereby to defend Singapore. So we built in certain element of national education as well. So using a game-based learning. Okay, so the purpose of this game, right, is to make four of them work together to defend attack from other countries, actually, or any intruders in Singapore. Okay, so that's the background story. But at the end of the day, the concept is to make use of angle of elevation and angle of depression. Okay, so there are four of them in the team, so everyone will have different role to play, actually. So of course there are some tools that will help them, the protractor, the ruler, to measure the distance and so on and so on. Okay, so how fast and all. So once we start, then there's the battle phase. For other countries, I'm not too sure, but for Singapore, mother tongue teaching is actually quite a challenge.
Yes.
Yeah. So we actually developed this game to teach idiom to the kids as well. So if you are familiar, this is called the Romance of the Three Kingdoms, the San Guo Yan Yi in Chinese actually. So we made use of this game to actually teach them Chinese idioms and all as well. So we'll bring students in to come and teach them certain idioms in Chinese. Okay? Yeah. So same thing, four in a team. Even though if you don't know Chinese, just join the game. Okay, so we'll start the war. So we'll choose which actually. So there are different games actually to help them learn the Chinese easier. Okay. So 6 minutes. Yeah, we'll start. Okay. So we're supposed to break the bridge to look for the word for the idioms. Yeah. So we're supposed to break, then we will. Up the word here. So I have got one right.
Okay.
Yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 4, so that they know the sequence of the phrase.
Okay, let's look at the first one. Do you agree? What is good about this set of words? Your friends, answer. Do you agree? It's a long way. Is this wrong?
No.
No, but I say do all your work using the identity, right? So how would you change this? Change the order? Which order? Okay, let's go back to identity. Yes, special rule. The answer is not wrong, alright? But if we were to use the identity, how would you change the answer? A equals to, in this case, what is your A? 4x. What's your B? 3y. Good. So, how do I change this formula? I get A squared. This part, right? What will you do? 2. Remember? Substitute, right? So, this will be what?
Okay.